Vercel's front-end cloud has a really powerful feature you may have never heard of, and it's called skew protection. Skew protection helps your server and your client stay in sync, even if you're deploying many times per day. In this video, I'm going to show you a demo of how it works, the problem it solves, and give you some resources to learn more. At a high level, skew protection helps prevent against version skew. And if you haven't heard of this, it's okay. Version skew happens when you have a distributed system and you have multiple versions of your application all being consumed by different clients. So user A requests a version of your application that maybe is different from user B. And those assets, unless they're atomic, are going to be different and they're going to change based on that deployment. Now, Vercel's platform is in a unique position to solve this problem because we have atomic immutable deployment URLs that you get for every Git push. So let's look at a demo with a Next.js app. First, we're going to talk about the static assets. So every time you make a new deployment, your site loads some new files, like JavaScript files or CSS files. And if you look inside the head of your Next.js app, you're going to notice that some of these URLs have this unique hash in the URL. That means that for this CSS file, if I pop over to the network tab and I click on it, because this URL is unique, I can safely add very aggressive caching headers. So I've got a really large max age and I've marked this as immutable. So we know it's not going to change. That's really helpful because you can guarantee that when you run a new build and your code changes, we're going to output a new version of this file that is different. But that is problematic if one version of your application is open in a browser and another user requests a new version of your application, but you've deployed in the middle. So let's take a look at what happens here. So if I go over to my editor, I've changed this line from V1 to V2. You can see that I have V1 currently loaded in the browser, and I've changed this to V2 and I pushed this commit to GitHub. When I pushed it to GitHub, it kicked off a new build of my application. So now I have two versions of my application. I have one that's loaded the assets from V1. And then if I take this and I make a new version, now you can see we have V2. So V1 and V2. Now what's going to happen if I go here and let's say I say test, I submit on V2, everything's fine. But if I go back to V1, I do test, a server-side exception has occurred. So what happened was my client on V1 tried to request a server endpoint for my server action that no longer had the same ID as it did when it was on V1. So ideally, wouldn't it be great if there was a way to take that and reroute it to the correct version all the time? Well, for Vercel customers on paid plans, so on Pro or Enterprise, if I just pop over to my settings for my project and go down to advanced, there's skew protection, which I can turn on. So I'm going to enable this and we can have the maximum age here of 12 hours to persist that. And we're going to go back to here. We're going to make this V3. We can make a new commit V3 and we'll push this to GitHub. Okay. So I pushed two new deployments. I have V3 and I have V4. On this version, I've loaded up V3 in the browser and then I pushed a new version of V4 here. So if I reload, I'll see V4 here. So I've got these two different versions. So I can do test 3 here. We'll do test 3. I hit submit. It makes a post request back to itself and it's a 200. So everything works as expected. If I go down, I can see this deployment ID that's attached. I look at the response and I see it's correctly version 3 for my application. Now you'll also notice if you go look at the head that these assets have this deployment ID appended into the unique URLs. So this is how Vercel and Next.js or other frameworks like SvelteKit or Quick that support skew protection on Vercel are able to make these connections, even if you're frequently making deployments, to ensure that you always load the right assets or you call the correct API or backend function without you having to do any manual wiring up of these bits. And just for good measure, I figured I'd show the runtime logs for our project showing the one request where we had version skew and we had that backend error, but then the other ones that have been able to post successfully. So that's skew protection. That's how you can prevent against version skew on paid Vercel plans. Again, this works with Next.js, SvelteKit, and Quick today, but it's available for all frameworks. So if you'd like to see your favorite framework support using skew protection on Vercel, let us know and we'd love to work with them. But yeah, that's it. Peace.